You can build a virtual production studio in your living room with just your phone and a TV.
I'm using a mix of Cuebric and Unreal Engine. Cuebric to generate all the content and Unreal is my camera tracker and media server. Let's go over what virtual production is. Virtual production typically involves using CGI and real-time rendering to enhance production efficiency and allow for more creative possibilities. Volume stages are large spaces equipped with LED screens displaying all these backgrounds in a dynamic space. Some of the shows and movies that use this were The Mandalorian, The Lion King, and the new Percy Jackson series. Virtual production allows for us to do real-time visual effects and actually have the actors on the scene that they're meant to be performing in, allowing for much better performances. This technology is hard to replicate with extremely powerful PCs needing to be used to render the environments. But Cuebric makes this easier. So we're going to start off with a full workflow of how I made the scene in Cuebric and Unreal. So today I'm going to create a kind of cyberpunk scene. So I have a prompt that I used before. So we're going to generate that scene. So looking through the options, I think I'm going to try and separate this into two kind of planes, because I can see that there's a nice little split right there that could work really well with the depth. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and do that with depth segmentation first. So we're going to apply our depth segmentation. And then it's around there. So then I'm going to add that segment to where that was about there. And then I'm gonna add that segment. I'm gonna grab the in painting tool and I am going to just carefully go over the rougher edges. Let's in paint that. Cool. So then let me bring the foreground to the foreground and unhide that. And then we can use Parallax Preview and see, yep, that gives us like just enough of like a little bit of depth. Very nice. You don't have to be too meticulous with this because of the fact that this is going to be the background, is I'm going to super scale both of these. So go to the super scale tool and I super scale firstly the foreground. And then I'm going to super scale the background. So I gotta make sure I have the background selected. So here, and then I'm gonna super scale that. Cool, so now that I have both my images upscaled, I'm then going to head to the segmentation tool and I'm gonna export depth maps. And that is gonna put both the selected images and their corresponding depth maps inside of just one folder. From there, we're gonna head over to Unreal. So I'm gonna start a new film, video, and live events. Okay, so now that we're inside of Unreal, we're gonna first enable some plugins right out the gate. We're first gonna enable the modeling tools editor. That'll help give us the displacement. I'm not gonna restart it yet. I'm gonna enable the virtual camera. And it is this one. I already have it. Next, I'm going to add the Apple AR kit. I already have that one too. It's this one up here. And then pixel streaming. It'll be this one right here. Where we also need a plugin called Live Link. And that'll be this one right here. So that should be all five plugins that we need. I am going to drag and drop that depth map package that we just made. So that's going to include all of our images and all of our depth maps. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get rid of some of the stuff that we don't need from here. So we don't need the checkpoint. We don't need the sphere reflection capture. And I don't believe we need the skylight either. Let's head into starter content and grab some shapes. We're gonna grab a plane and I just like to separate this into a different folder. And then I like to rename them foreground. And then you're going to name this background. Brilliant. All right, so we're gonna bring the background plate in, make sure that it is 16 by 9. Then we're gonna rotate this way 90 degrees, and I'm gonna rotate it forward 90 degrees. Awesome. Then we're gonna head into the content drawer, and we're gonna drag and drop our first plate onto it. So it'll automatically cut off the side, and then we're gonna head into the modeling tab. We're gonna head to deform, and then we are gonna head into displace. All right, once we're in this tab, let's make sure that we have it set to texture 2D map. And we're gonna make sure that it picks the correct depth map. So this is the correct one for that image. And then we're gonna change the subdivisions to 100, make sure it's there. And then we're gonna change the displace intensity to, let's try 500. Cool, that gives us, you know, a good amount of depth, which is quite nice. So we're gonna hit accept on that. And that's the reason why we did it in a different content drawer, is it basically changes that primitive shape. All right, so now let's bring in a second plane. Once again, 16 by 9, rotate. Then we're gonna once again apply the foreground image to it. And then we're gonna go into the modeling tab, displace, correct depth map this time. And then I'm gonna increase this one to about 1,000, I think. And I'm gonna hit accept. Cool, so if we move this one forward a little bit and we lift it just a little, what we can do is we can kind of position our camera a little bit to kind of see what it's gonna look like. All right, so in lit, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn off the light source, and then we're gonna head into each of the materials. So we have this material. And then what I like to do is I like to take the RGB and plug that into the emission color. And then you have to make sure you hit apply at the top. We'll head into the other one real quick. So we'll open up that material. And once again, we'll plug the RGB into the emission. We'll hit apply and we'll hit save. And then we'll exit out. Boom. So now they both have emission to them when it is lit. What we're gonna do then is we can close this tab now. We are going to add a new virtual production VCam actor. Cool, so now you are kind of piloting the VCam. So what we can do is we can kind of line it up just a little bit with where we want it to be. I kind of want it around there. And then we can take the background element, we can scale it up just a little bit. We can also move it so that the straight kind of aligns a bit better. Boom, boom. Pull it forward a little bit. Nice. Nice, that looks good. Let's check that in lit for a second. Yep, that looks good. We do have to change some more things in the project settings. So first thing we need to do is we need to come down to rendering. We change this. So we need to head into the pixel buffer. And then we can change that from 10-bit to 8-bit. That'll just make it a little easier on your PC or whatever you're running this on. Then we're gonna head all the way down to UDP messaging, and then in the unicast endpoint, let's make sure that that is the same as our IP address, and then you're going to hit restart. Cool, with all of that done, we are then going to head over to our phone.
Yeah.
And we are going to head into the Live Link VCam app. Make sure the IP address entered in VCam is the same as it is on your phone, and then I'm going to hit connect. All right, now I can see Unreal on my phone, but we're gonna head into this Live Link panel right here, which is gonna be in Window Virtual Production Live Link, if you can't find it, source. And then in Message Bus Source, your camera should show up. After that, your camera is fully tracked to the scene, and inside the phone, you can actually change your lens settings on the left there. To get rid of the UI, head into the VCAM component, go to your output providers, and then select the first one, and under UMS display, select none. Then go into the top left little menu and disable anything you don't want to see, and then you can turn on immersive mode. Plug your laptop or desktop into a TV, and boom, you have your scene. Let's talk about lighting a little bit. It's important to pick a scene that you know that you can light for. If you pick an exterior scene with a lot of light, it is going to require a really high power and diffuse light to make it look realistic. It's one of the reasons I chose the scenes I did. This scene has a bunch of contrasting colors which I can replicate with my RGB lights. Just having one or two different colors in the correct place is enough to sell the effect. The next step is your camera. So what you want to do is you want to mount your phone to the top of your camera so that it copies the transformed data in the real world and puts it into your virtual production scene. I would suggest then putting your camera on some kind of slider so it's easily maneuverable, and from there you have a camera that is matching to your virtual scene. From there, the only limit is your creativity. This is a game changer for product photographers, short film creators, and content creators. We at Cuebric would love to see what you create, so please feel free to tag us in anything you make. And we also have a Discord as well that you can join if you want to post some of your work.